The next one is, how is the solar energy acquired for us? How do we get the solar energy? See, as we all know, the primary source of solar energy, what we are getting is the sun. Sun is the principal source of energy of the solar, which releases energy for us. Basing on the energy which is received for us from the sun, we have various points to analyze on this. The first point is the energy taken from sun by earth is called solar energy. The energy which is released by sun is called solar energy, which is absorbed by the earth. And when it is received by the earth, you not only get normal sun rays, in these sun rays, you also get the UV rays. These UV rays are blocked or stopped by the greenhouse effect, or like ozone layer, O3. Formula of ozone layer is ozone layer. This ozone layer protects the earth from the dangerous ultraviolet rays. Now moving on to the other parts of the energy, as solar energy is emitted from the sun, and if we have the 1/3 of the energy of the sun getting reflected back towards the atmosphere, and another 1/3 is blocked by the clouds and the dust which is present in the atmosphere. So 1/3 is blocked for mirror effect and clouds. So this 1/3 mirror effect and 1/3 clouds leaves the energy outside. The remaining energy only, the earth consumes it or absorbs it into its day-to-day activities of the performance of the human beings, and where we feel the effect of this. And again, in this also we have the variation of, depending on the corners of the earth, again we have the variation of the receiving of the earth. What are the variations that we have for us? What are the other effects? Which region gets more energy, which region gets less energy? We'll see now. Now, what is the reason for the earth to receive various kinds in various places? Like near the equator, it receives more rainfall, or above from the equator, it gets less amount of sun rays when compared to the places which are nearby to the equator. For that, we have to study the sun rays and inclination of the earth. Inclination of the earth. See, sun is completely at the center, and we have the rotation of the earth moving around. So this movement of sun around makes the different kinds of seasons, different kind of receiving the sun rays at different places. To understand this better, we have to understand the concept of the earth very clearly. Imagine that, suppose this is a part of the earth where this would be an imaginary equator line, this would be the Tropic of Cancer, the Tropic of Capricorn, this would be the poles region. And if you move on to analyze the exact reality of this one, and if suppose this is the sun and the releasing of the sun rays reaches to the earth the exact angle at equatorial point, and here the sun rays falls directly on the earth, there is no disturbance much, so the maximum effect of the sun energy what we are getting is coming into the equatorial belt. But as we move on to the parts far away from the equator, there the distance traveled by the solar energy or the waves of sun rays is farther than the places which are nearby to the equator. Because of this, this moves to other places and they gets diverted into the atmosphere. So the percentage of energy which is received by the places which are nearby to the equator is more when compared to the places which are away from the equator. This is one of the basic reasons why the sun rays and the angle of incidence of the earth is required. Now this concept, see here, the sun rays and the earth angle here is 90 degrees. Here it is 45 degrees. So it goes on changing. This angle brings a variation in the effect of the sun's rays which are getting connected with the earth. This angle which is showing us the differences is known as the angle of incidence. It is the angle of incidence which brings the variation on the sun rays to reach to the earth. It's nothing but the earth and the sun are not connected in the same length of the issue, and we have a very long distance of like 150 million kilometers of distance between earth and the sun, and the energy which has to travel here has to travel this distance plus the extra distance which is to be drawn from here. You can see here, if it is nearby to the equator, the energy is directly connecting it here. So this extra distance has to be drawn or to be traveled by the waves, and if it goes to the poles, it has to travel such a long distance to go to the poles. So this is the angle of incidence which brings the variation for us. So if you understand the angle of incidence very clearly, automatically you can understand what is the reason, like near the equator the people are dark colored, we receive heavy amount of sun rays directly near the equator. When it moves on away from the equator, you get the connectivity very less. What about the heat? We'll discuss now.